Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorials on tips and tricks in Wallacei tutorial series. In this tutorial I would like to show you the new component we just added to our ecosystem. It's called distribute to grid. With this component you can easily distribute the exported phenotypes and the data and fitness values associated with those phenotypes onto a grid in runner scene very easily. To show you how this works, I'm just gonna go through this example file, run the simulation very quickly for 10 generation count and 10 generation size. Simulation finished, and we do our analysis. We go to tab 3, decide what we would like to have exported. Let's say 2 generations, a couple of individuals from Pareto front, and remember, you go back to Grasshopper, you enable your phenotype, back to Wallacei, export. Now the export process has been initiated. We wait until the export process finished, and yep, it's finished. We go back to Rhino and Grasshopper. Now we can use this component to easily distribute everything onto a grid. Two necessary inputs are fitness values and Wallacei phenotypes. Connect to the phenotype, connect to fitness value, and done. By default, the preview is off because it makes it faster. You can turn on the preview when you connect everything, and then you have your phenotypes onto a grid with the data associated with each phenotype laid out onto a grid perfectly. Some of you may have used data input and output to record a value. You can also connect this to data input and plot that value onto a grid as well. As you can see, it has size X and size Y. You can customize the size of the grid in X and Y direction. You can also customize your text size by an inputting a number. There is this option here, input called option. So essentially with this input you can choose which data type from your Wallacei phenotype you would like to distribute onto a grid. By default the value is 0, however if you would like to only have your B-Ribbon geometries, you can put it the value on 1. I'm just gonna show you how this looks. So essentially now I am only outputting the geometries, the B-Rep, and if I take a look at this here, the geometries has an output, however the mesh is not outputting anything. If I would like to just output the mesh, I'm gonna number 2, it just outputs the mesh, and as you can see geometry 0 and the mesh has an output. Similar fashion for just the numbers. If you would like to have only the numbers, you can simply just plot the numbers. This helps when you're dealing with a massive geometry, especially when it comes to the B-Rep and surfaces. Sometimes this operation might be heavy and you might only want to output and distribute the mesh onto a grid, which makes it extremely fast and smooth. Another important thing to note here is that this component keeps the data structure of your phenotype the way they were connected to Wallacei component. So essentially if I take a look at the data structure here for the B-Rep, we have this data structure. This component will divide, will decode the phenotypes into the B-Reps, mesh and numbers. So our geometries, which right now is not being outputted, if I output them, as you can see, as geometries, the output is keeping the data structure of the inputted phenotype as well. The first two digits are generation address and individual in that generation, and the second two digits are actually the digits that the data structure of the inputted phenotype. Why? So this is a very important and useful method for people who would like to track their geometry and their phenotype to put the different types of and different parts of their phenotype, like floors, structures, and facade, into different tree structures to be able to take advantage of them later on in the simulation and in their design process. This way they can keep track of their data structure. It's a similar thing for the mesh and for the numbers. The other thing that it's worth mentioning is, as you remember, if you watched the tutorial series, Wallacei phenotype accepts BREP, mesh, and even numbers. If you would like to record a number like the area size, the structural performance, number of panels, and to record that what's happening to them throughout the simulation, you can record them through connecting them to the phenotype. And these numbers, as you can see here, they also can be plotted onto the grid. And simply, after plotting them onto a grid, you can bake them, have them on the rhino scene, and simply visualize your phenotypes. We also output the grid location of this grid, which eventually led the users to plot even more information next to their phenotype, like taking advantage of other Wallacei analytic components to plot the diamond charts and other charts. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoy it. Make sure you download the latest release, because the latest release has this component in it. And see you in the next one.